ASA is a material that is not commonly used in 3D printing as PLA or ABS. Basically, ASA is pretty similar regarding its properties and behavior to normal ABS, with one major difference. ABS is not a material that can handle direct sunlight very well and will get brittle over time. This is where ASA has its benefits, since it's very resistant to UV light and is therefore, for example, used in the plastic parts of your car. Plastika Trček, I'm quite sure that I didn't pronounce that correctly, a Slovenian filament manufacturer contacted me a while ago and asked me if I wanted to test one of their materials. Since I never worked with ASA filament at that point, they shipped me a roll of theirs. It comes at a low price of around 20 euros per kilogram of material. It's very nice of them that they fill the roll up all the way with material, but unfortunately, during my tests, the filament regularly jumped off the roll and got tangled in the spool holder. I ended up putting two pieces of cardboard around the roll to prevent that from happening. The ASA has a very similar smell as ABS during printing, and I had to move the printer into another room because I wasn't comfortable having the odor in my office. I tried printing temperatures from 235 centigrade to 275 centigrade, which all worked fine quality wise, but ended up printing all the test samples at 265 centigrade. The manufacturer recommends using the part cooling fan at a low setting for the best printing performance. I printed a test model and varied the fan speed from 0 to 35% and chose 20% as it was the best compromise between print quality and layer adhesion. All lower settings resulted in drooping of overhangs and bridges. I printed all the test parts without an enclosure and did not have any problem with layer separation, and warping also didn't seem to be a huge problem. I tried using an enclosure during my tests, but it didn't improve the material properties in my tests a lot. The ASA stuck very well to the glue stick covered PEI print bed of my Prusa, which was heated to 100 degrees. Some of the parts even stuck too well, which ended up in a broken part or a piece of PEI being ripped out. Print quality was decent for an ABS-like material, only the grey color of the filament seemed to exaggerate the surface imperfection of the 3D Banshee I printed. The ASA showed no stringing at all, and with a small amount of cooling air, even the tiny needles printed flawlessly. Overhangs printed well up to 65 degrees and then started to droop. This might be improvable by more cooling, but then sacrificing layer adhesion. Bridging was okay even at the biggest bridge, but you were able to see how the material was slightly carried away by the cooling air blowing on it. I tried smoothing one of the parts in acetone vapor, which worked out, but I had the feeling that it took a little longer than with regular ABS. Now to the material tests. The lying specimens showed an average tensile strength of 38 MPa, which is quite comparable to ABS. Layer adhesion was not the greatest, and the upright specimens were only able to withstand 60% of the load before they failed. With a tensile modulus of 1400 MPa, this ASA is one of the less rigid materials with a little more than half of the stiffness of PLA. Impact resistance was good, and the specimens that were printed lying were able to absorb around 30% of the energy of the impact hammer and didn't even break all the way through, ending up with an impact strength of 18 kilojoules per square meter. With the standing specimens, the layer adhesion problem popped up again, and they were only able to absorb 5% of the hammer's energy, nicely breaking in between the layers. The hooks I tested failed at 48 kg for the one printed on the bed and 16 kg for the upright one. The vapor smoothed hook was able to withstand a little more load, probably because the layer lines that act as notches were smoothed, but still broke clean in between the layers. The temperature test showed that the material started to soften at around 100 degrees Celsius and totally failed at 110 degrees Celsius, which is remarkable and makes it well usable for many temperature demanding applications. Overall, I did not have the worst experience with ASA. It is nicely printable without an enclosure, is mechanically resistant if you are not purely loading it in between the layers, and has a great temperature resistance. Combined with its UV resistance, the Slovenian ASA is probably well suited for lots of outdoor applications. You can find links to the manufacturer and the test methods I used down in the description. The detailed test report, together with print profile and all the test samples, are available for my Patreons. If you enjoyed the video and learned something, then hit the like button. If you have suggestions and comments about my methods, please leave them down below and let me know what other materials you would like to see me investigate in the future. Until then, thanks for watching, auf Wiedersehen, and I will see you next time.